Hey, what's up guys, TechoSoul here. So after reviewing Samsung QN90D 43-inch TV, I was intrigued to try out some ambient lighting to enhance the vibe, especially that newer Samsung TVs now support Philips Hue natively through an app. So I went ahead and got the Philips Gradient Lightstrip designed for 55-inch TVs. That's the smallest size available. As of now, there is no specific one for 43-inch TVs. And we're going to check if it's going to work well with our QN90D 43-inch. It's my first time trying this out, so we'll work through the process together. I got the light strip along with the Hue bridge, since it's my first Hue product, so I'll need the bridge to connect to it. What got me into believing this might work is because Philips light strips typically cover only the top and the two sides, not the bottom one. So let's unbox it. Inside we'll find the light strip itself, some instructions, a power adapter, the lightbox controller which we'll attach to the back of the TV. Then we got 3 straight mounts to hold the lid and 2 for corner side. That's it for the light strip. Instead is the Hue bridge. We got the bridge device and it has this button in the middle to establish the connection between the TV or the phone app and the bridge itself. It has a LAN port that we need to connect to the internet modem or router to connect to the network. Comes also with some instructions, a LAN cable, a power adapter. The instructions suggest ensuring it aligns with the arrows on the lid and the top mount. Then placing the corners and finally the straight bottom ones and the controller box. And it fits just fine. It was actually pretty simple. I just followed the guideline and for the little part remaining, I twisted them and used a cable organizer clip I happen to have to keep them straight to the end. So it's possible to install it on a 43-inch with no issues. The next step is connecting the Hue bridge. The instructions say to connect it via the LAN cable it comes with directly to your internet modem or router. Then using the app, it will discover all the Hue devices through the same connection. After connecting the Hue bridge, I got the phone app and the process is pretty easy. It asks you to press the middle button to establish the connection to your phone and then create our home on the app and that's it. Then you can search for the RGB strip, make sure it's connected to power by then. And here it found it. You can give it a name and choose an icon. The next step says here on attaching it. I already have it done, but here the instructions say to ensure that the back of your TV is dust free so the mounts adhere well. If the strips are the same size as your TV, place them from 5 to 10 cm away from the edge. Otherwise, if your TV is smaller, they say to move them inward towards the center. However, on my QN90D, you can see the speakers will be blocked if I placed it more towards the center. Also, they wouldn't stick anymore in this area. Here it shows you how to attach the mount, starting with the top middle one and for the top corners, then install the straight bottom ones and finally the controller. Then finally attach the RGB strips to the mount and that's it. So as you can see, it's pretty straightforward. Once we are in, we'll create a new room and drag our strip to it. In the app dashboard, you can turn the lights on or off, control brightness, whole synchronizing. We got variety of options, such as Philips Hue Play HDMI Sync Box, Spotify, Smart Syncs, and the cool thing that was a selling point for me is that it supports natively newer Samsung TVs since the 2022 models. We'll get to that part specifically in a bit. Additionally, it can also work with a PC or Mac. I just want to show that in the settings tab, make sure to run the software update for both the Hue bridge and the RGB strip. Alright, let's get into trying them out. Of course, you can control them on the phone app to make scenes, etc. What will be more interesting is synchronizing them with a display. So I'm going ahead and use the Hue PC app first. It's free and you can download it from this page. After connecting it to the bridge, we now have full control over the light. We can turn them on or off, control brightness, and turn on the synchronizing by clicking this button. And we can choose between video, music, and game mode. There's also control over the intensity of ambient shifting for syncing with the display and use of audio effects. If you turn off syncing, you can use the scenes mode as well. Going to the settings, we can change some stuff, like here in the general, if you have Razer and Corsair components, you can integrate your devices with them. And make sure to choose CPU to high performance to have a smooth transition. Here we have some app related settings, like you can activate it to start with the system startup, change the default syncing mode and the low third party control to the Hue Sync. In the display tab, we can select the display to sync with, and in the audio preference, we can select the output device to sync with. Also, if you want to define shortcut hotkeys, you can do so in here. Finally, in the game preference, we can add games to change some specific settings based on that game. I'm going to add Cyberpunk 2077 so we can have it to auto start game mode as soon as the game launched and add audio effect sync. You can see it's pretty fluid and dynamic experience. Now I know many of you may be familiar with TV ambient light, but for a first timer, it really got to me and feels so immersive. Like I feel it's one of the best investments I made recently. Here we can see the difference in intensity levels. Not much difference, but you can see what is changing is sensitivity. The subtle is more smooth, while extreme is more sensitive to light change and therefore maybe too reactive. It just depends on the typology of scene, but I would suggest you switch between them to know which one you like the most. Next, let's get to sync it with the Hue Sync app dedicated for Samsung TVs. On the QN90D, by going to the Daily Blast section, we can find the Hue app in here. To have it directly on the TV instead of other methods, we'll need to get a subscription. While I'm not a huge fan of paying for a subscription for two devices I bought already, especially since it's not that cheap as well, being at €3 monthly in my case, or a one-time payment for only this TV unit for €130. So what I can understand is that if I use another TV, it won't be transferred, while the monthly subscription can be used on three different TVs at the same time. Anyway, I'll go ahead and give it a try. So after subscribing, I did the installation process. It's pretty easy, much similar to when we paired it to the phone app. And here it is. Here you can see as soon as we press the sync button, it will immediately start to work with the TV. We can choose between video, game, and music modes here as well. And we can change the intensity and the brightness. In the settings, we can activate the auto synchronizing. And if we have that option enabled, when you turn the TV off and turn it back on, it will start the synchronizing automatically without you having to start the app all over again, making it more convenient. And here is a small demo of the Samsung TV app doing the synchronizing this time. It's pretty responsive and I got no issues with it. Thank you. Also for gaming consoles such as PS5, it works pretty well, and the same goes for the Nintendo Switch. Now I would like to show you this. If you open the PC app while it's synchronizing on Samsung TV app, it would indicate that it's currently syncing with the TV app. Therefore, even on PC, you can still have the ambient light working without depending on the PC app anymore. So the Hue app found on Samsung TVs is basically all in one place to synchronize across all your devices hassle-free. While I wish we didn't have to pay for it, but honestly it's very convenient and could give you the best experience across anything you play on TV without further setups. And alright guys, that was it for this video. So if you've been looking for an RGB ambient light for your 43-inch TV, and especially if you have a Samsung TV from the 2022, then Philips Hue Play Gradient Lightstrip 55 is a good option. In my case, I tried it on the Samsung QN90D 43-inch TV that I reviewed as well recently. You can check it out in this suggested video in here. So I hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions about it, please don't hesitate to ask in the comment section. And if you liked this video, give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. It would be awesome to have you along. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.